You're strolling along on a fresh spring day, on your way to an important appointment, perhaps an interview or a date. You've blow-dried your hair, and you're wearing that nice cashmere jumper you got for Christmas. When suddenly, the clouds darken and you feel the first drop of what is about to be cascading sheets of rain. You're a good 100 meters from your nearest cover, but how should you get there? Will frantically dashing into the rain actually get you wetter than if you calmly continue to stroll through it?
I'm Stu, this is Debunked, and we're here to sort the truths from the myths and the facts from the misconceptions.
It would be fair to say that a natural response to finding yourself at the mercy of the elements is to run, the thinking being that less time in the rain means less rain on you. Sounds reasonable, right? Well, perhaps not. For decades, people have speculated that running through the rain may, somewhat counterintuitively, result in you actually getting wetter than if you just walked. This is based on the idea that, although you'll spend less time in the rain if you reach your destination faster, moving quickly through the rain that is falling in front of you will mean you hit more raindrops than if you just walked, resulting in a wetter you when you arrive at where you want to be. Let's look at it a little closer. Assuming that the rain in which you find yourself is falling consistently and vertically downwards, and that's already quite the assumption, over the same period of time, you'll be hit by the same number of raindrops regardless of your speed. This is because it doesn't matter how fast you're going. Moving out of the way of a falling drop of rain is always going to move you into the path of another one at exactly the same rate. As a result, it actually works out that in any given period of time in which you're in the rain, you'll actually get less wet by standing still. Moving through the rain means that in addition to the rain falling directly on top of you, more raindrops will hit your body head-on as you move. Like rain hitting you from above, this amount is also constant. It doesn't matter specifically how fast you're going, because moving out of the way of one drop moves you into the way of another. Of course, this doesn't get to the core of the issue. Obviously, standing still literally doesn't get you anywhere. And you probably want to be indoors as soon as possible when it starts chucking it down, rather than just standing there getting drenched. But before we get moving, we'd like to introduce you to Magellan TV, who have made this video possible. Magellan TV is a premium documentary streaming service hosting thousands of hours of docuseries and feature films, with the largest collection of science content anywhere, which you can watch on practically any device. Plus, with new programs added every week, why not take advantage of a 1 month free trial by clicking on our link in the description. Right, the question at hand is whether walking or running to your destination will leave you drier when you arrive. If you're actively trying to get out of the rain, as the question assumes, although the speed at which you're moving doesn't affect how many raindrops will hit you, the amount of time you spend exposed to rain very much does, and that is dependent on how fast you're moving to get there. So yes, running through the rain does mean that you'll end up drier, but how much drier? Is the difference significant enough to justify the effort?
Lucky for us, a whole bunch of theoretical and practical studies have been conducted on this very topic, so we can stay nice and dry.
Firstly, we have Harvard mathematician David E. Bell, who published a paper back in 1976 and found that even if you're running at a speed comparable to that of a professional sprinter, which, let's face it, you probably aren't, you'll only get about 10% less wet. Then in 1987, physicist Alessandro De Angelis made his own assessment of the problem and seemed to be broadly in agreement with Bell, concluding pretty brusquely that
by running faster, you get less wet, but the benefit that you get beyond the speed of a brisk walk does not justify the supplementary effort.
This obviously begs the question, is it worth expending the energy to run for such a small benefit?
In 1996, a pair of meteorologists decided to throw their hypothetical hats into the proverbial ring, suspecting that previous purely hypothetical studies had overestimated the average speed at which people walk. They also wanted control over certain variables, including the effects of wind and the fact that runners tend to lean forward. Using themselves as test subjects, one of the intrepid researchers walked through a 100-meter track while being rained on, while the other academic ran. When their relative wetness was assessed, they found that the runner was 40% drier than the walker, a difference that might actually justify the effort it takes to speed up.
But the boffins haven't stopped there. In their voracious quest for knowledge, scientists have also factored in things like wind direction and intensity.
For instance, our old pal Bell pointed out in his study that when rain is falling, either vertically or the wind is blowing it towards you at an angle, the faster you run, the less wet you will get over the same distance. So theoretically, you should try to run as fast as possible. However, if the wind is blowing the rain at you from behind, you should still run, but this time there is actually an optimal speed at which you need to move that is equal to that of the wind. Running either slower or faster than this speed reduces how relatively dry you'll be upon arrival compared to walking. These claims were expanded upon by another study entitled Whether or Not to Run in the Rain, written by another Italian called Franco Bocci. He found that one's exposure to rain also depends somewhat on body shape. For people who are particularly thin, there might be an optimal speed at which to move, whereas for most other people, the best strategy is generally just leg it as fast as you can. So, as you can see, the question of whether or not to run or walk in the rain throws up a range of unexpected concerns and considerations. And indeed, much of the scientific discussion of this issue deals with very specific theoretical aspects of the problem that aren't at all practical to consider in the real world. I don't know about you, but having to factor in wind speed and direction, as well as how fat you are, on whether to walk or run through the rain feels just a little like overdoing it. But it appears pretty clear that running in the rain will leave you drier upon arrival when compared to walking, perhaps up to as much as 40% drier. On a human level, however, whether or not it's worth rushing through the rain is entirely your personal preference. Maybe you just hate being rained on, and trying to avoid getting wet is your primary concern. But many people might honestly prefer to get wetter if running means a higher chance of splashing yourself in puddles, tripping over, or arriving at your destination not only wet, but hot and sweaty too.
It's also a simple fact that any amount of physical exertion is horrible. I don't want to do it, and you can't make me.
If you enjoyed this topic and would like to learn more about how physics of the everyday affects your life, then check out Magellan TV's fascinating series, The Amazing World of Gravity, and learn about how it can affect your weight, height, and posture, and even the rate at which you age. Just click on the link in the description and grab yourself a 1-month free trial. Thanks for watching, and thank you to our Patreon supporters. Your names are on screen now. I'll see you next time.